Today we're going into my clinic. I'm going to demonstrate exactly a device to remove facial fat. Why did that device remove my facial fat? My face is ruined after I got RF microneedling, Ulthera, thermage, RF, whatever it be. This is going to explain it fully and finally. Now, if you look at this picture here, that's submental fat reduced from injections of lipolysis. This picture here, that's buccal fat removal, where people intentionally get fat removed from their face. This video here is a before and after of a face slimming procedure I do in my clinic to reduce some fat down here and lift the upper base to give that Korean V-line look. And so there are many reasons to do it and to intentionally remove your fat, because as we age, the fat displaces, meaning it sags, it moves down, you get collagen loss. So there's good and there's bad. But let's go into my clinic. I'll show you exactly the device and why these things happen. Okay, I wanted to bring you this video today to show you a device that removes facial fat. What I get asked all the time is, I'm afraid my device is going to ruin my facial fat. Today I'm going to show you the device, show you the settings on the device, all the variables you can change, but it's one of several devices I use in my clinic. In fact, I'm going to treat someone right now to tighten the lower face, remove submental fat, and I'm going to show you on the device why it's absolutely important who does your treatment, less so than the device. But let's come to this device here, and you can check out the screen here. And what I want to show you are the levels. So I can change the energy level here. I can move up as far as 5, that's going to be very painful. I can move down to 1, that's less energy. But here's the important thing for fat. It is the time. So I can move it down. I'm going to do 3 passes. The first one's going to be somewhere around 180 milliseconds. I'm going to show you what that looks like, because I'll show you, I'm going to adjust this to a very light setting. I want you to look at the needles. Okay, I'll fire the device now, and you can look at the needles here. Okay. Okay, here we go. And you can see, we're good there. So you can see that the needles are coming up, and they're just a little bit. You see that? That's a very quick pulse, and it's very superficial. I'm going to show you what happens when I go to the fat layer now. Look at the difference in the needles. Do you see how far it's going into the fat? That's perfect, but guess what? It's still a very quick setting. I'm going to come down here, and I'm going to change the time, the duration of the heat. Now, if I did this in the upper face, okay, I'm going to change that to a second, 1,000 milliseconds. Now, if I did this in the face, in meaning the forehead or around the eyes, watch how deep it goes. Standby on. You see that pulse? Deep and long. And that's going to get rid of fat. So if I do that in the wrong area, that's going to cause a problem, especially if I go and I change the level. So now let's say I have a high level of heat, a long pulse duration, and deep needles. That is your fat killing setting. And that's what would do it. Now, even if I took the time duration down, let's say you just come to 300 milliseconds. Now watch here. It's still going to be deep. Way too deep for under an eye. Way too deep for a forehead. Even though it's a quick hit of heat, that would be a problem. So the device is so important, not just the device. Your device needs to get to the certain depth. It needs to be able to have a certain pulse duration and a certain level of heat. But you can see where I can remove fat from the lower face, from the submentum, anywhere, but this is where I want it gone, because the fat pads do what? They displace the ligaments holding the face up. They kind of get lax and the face fat decreases, whereas you wouldn't want to do that in the upper face. So it gives you an idea that of the settings, not the device. So many people want to know, hey, is it this device? Is it that device? What are the settings? Every device is going to have a different set of settings that you can change. So the person needs to actually know what the device you're using, what your skin is,
in what part of the face?
People reach out to me on this channel and direct message or DM me quite often, send me their pictures and say, look at the disaster that happened to my face. What do I think? If you're getting value from these videos, click like and subscribe. I put a complete video up here on a procedure I did to reduce face fat for slimming purposes, but I want to hear, have you had problems with it or did you do it on purpose? Stay tuned, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.